other question I have is, what are you guys shooting for as far as a completed project? Are you shooting for a final design project, or are you shooting for a prototype?
Very good question.
What I mean is this thing, when you are done in April, okay, is this thing going to be production, something that's going to be production ready, or is this going to be a prototype that's going to require additional design reiterations to make it into a full product? Exactly. It's a prototype. Okay, so it's going to be a prototype. So because it's going to be a prototype, does it have to meet this functional size? You talked about, Andrew, being able to have to redesign the circuit card.
Yeah.
Okay, an impossibility at this level stage of the game, because to be honest with you, you don't know how to design a printed circuit board. That's a computer-based circuit board. Okay, you don't know how to do that. You weren't trained on how to do that. Okay, so doing that redesign, impossible. However, would that other card, that Freedom card, provide you better capabilities that could be designed out in another run, because this is just a prototype?
Absolutely. The other cards, there's a lot less factor in you to implement that type of identity.
So now, what I'm trying to drive you into something, okay, and help you out. Why don't you reevaluate your moving over to that? Because I'm going to be honest with you, Code Python is not going to be an easy thing. You have more capability with C programming than you are with the Code Python. Okay, and I'm not trying to tell you to take it. I think you have to go back and reevaluate your trade study on that decision.
Okay.
Because this is just a prototype.
Right.
Okay. You have your packaging, but you don't have to get all the electronics into the packaging. Am I wrong on that?
True.
Okay? Just as a thought.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to tell you what, to be successful in the programming, I think you need to stay with something that...
Yeah, because then we could have, that was our issue. Like, we had a professor helping us, and he knows C, he doesn't have Python, but because that board didn't have Bluetooth, we would have to have external Bluetooth capability. But yeah, being said, that being said,
when you re-spin the card, add the Bluetooth capability, right?
So help me understand, like, what makes this project IoT? Like, how would this differ from a just standard mechatronics project? What makes it, what's the IoT part of this?
So this is essentially a step towards an IoT future. More or less, given that we're using this hobby board, it's going to be in the realm of
in order to justify what you guys, otherwise you haven't changed your title, really. Otherwise, this is not an IoT project. I mean, you understand what I'm saying? Like, at least they should get Wi-Fi or something. I mean, find a way, that's easy, relatively easy.
Yes,
otherwise, I mean, you cannot call this an IoT project.
That's specifically one of our steps for the next semester. So the user interface is called you would implement
Does this Adafruit microcontroller has a Wi-Fi capability?
Yes.
It has. So that you should aim for that, absolutely. Otherwise, I mean, this is not an IoT project. Yeah.
So given that opportunity,
I just have one quick comment. Are you 3D printing the band?
Yes.
Part of your design? Don't be afraid of using commercial off-the-shelf items. Like, you can probably buy a pretty cheap watch band instead of trying to 3D print it. I think the main part of your project is everything else that goes in it, you know what I mean? So yeah, don't be afraid to kind of use what's available and then integrate it and make it your own. That would be your major project thing. So.
Yeah, we want to for our patients, and we can make it all
Yeah, that's what he's doing. My wife killed me.
What is that?
Try and keep it below budget. We're able to do that with some scraps from the Baja team that Dominic mentioned that he had for us. So that's really what made our budget work and how we're able to do this today. Up next, we have the real world budget. The only thing that differs between the two and the only thing we really thought we could add on is just time, because fabrication and modeling and testing, simulations, they're all very time intensive things, and they cost a lot of money to have a lot of people's time. So that came out to around $2,200 just for our light fingering.
So before we go into the actual design of the rig itself, a few specifications of it. These ones that are being passed around are only 80% of the size, so it is a little bit bigger. So it's around 8 inches in total length, 3.5 inches wide, and 2.75 inches tall. 3/4 of an inch comes from the top pegs. It is approximately 1.94 pounds, the actual PET model that is. And then it is also around 38 cubic inches in volume, which after calculations would take around 30 water bottles just like that to fill that. So going into the design itself, the pictures on the right show female and male clean system. This allows the bricks to be connected in a horizontal fashion and form these initial layers. And then the picture on the right shows the two pegs. Once again, they're 3/4 of an inch tall, and there's two of them at the center of each brick. These are essentially used for the vertical connection. So with that,